Hey, in this one I wanted to show you how you can detect overflow in C. And so here in my main you can see that I have a small example where I want to add A and B. And A is a bit less than int max and B is just 1. And so in this case, you can see it's all fine, it can add it. But as soon as I put a number that is a bit too large in B, you can see that it goes into the negative numbers and it overflows. And so one way to check this is, well, in C, like, overflow is undefined behavior, so you have to check it before you actually do the addition. So the way you would do this is if A is greater than the difference between it max and B, so if there isn't, like, enough numbers left in A, to add B, well, you can kind of know, you can know that it will overflow, like so. Let's just put a little backslash, like so. So in this case, you can actually detect that it will overflow. And there is another condition, like this is only if B is positive, and there is another condition if B is negative to check for the underflow. So that would be if A is int min plus 10, let's say, and then you want to add it, add some minus negative number to it. So here the A didn't had enough margin to add negative something B into it, and so we got an underflow. So you can see the result is positive when it should be negative. And there is other conditions like this for subtraction and multiplication, but of course it's a bit annoying to write. And so I discovered that in the C23 standard that came out, they added a new header called std checked I have to look it up, checked int, like so. Yeah, it's a nightmare to spell, but I assume CKD means checked. I'm gonna guess that. And in this header you have a few macros that can help you detect overflow. So you can use the checked add, for example, which as the first argument takes the address of the where you want to put the result of the addition. So in my case it's C, and then you just say the two operands, so in my case A and B, and let's say that C is there, and so on. And so this will just perform a regular addition, except that it will return true if it overflows, or zero if it didn't overflow. So you can actually store this in a variable and print overflow, like so, overflow. And this, well, let me go back to my max thing, like so. So this will overflow, and you can see that overflow was set to 1. And if I put it back to a number that wouldn't cause an overflow, overflow is 0. So that's how you can check. And of course, there is the same thing with checked sub. And there is also checked mul for multiplication. And those work, well, as you would expect. They perform the operation and return true if there was an overflow. And so, yeah, that's pretty much it. I would still compile your code, my code with, oops, with std is equal to C23. With C23 to make sure that you do have this header and it's all according to the standard. Otherwise, before C23, you have some compiler built-ins that can help you. So they have the same behavior. The thing is called in GCC, it's called built-in add overflow. And there is same ones for a built-in sub and built-in mul overflow, but those do the same thing, except you have to switch the arguments around, where the result is the last argument. but otherwise it's, or it should be should be the okay, I just made a typo. It's built-in, yes, with an L, like so. And so now overflow is zero, but yeah, same behavior as before, basically. If I cause an overflow, overflow will be set to one. And so yeah, that's basically it. I checked, and those macros are also supported by C-Lang, if that's the compiler you use. But yeah, that's about it. A convenient way to check for overflow with addition, subtraction, and multiplication. Yeah, that's good that it's a standard, and I'll see you in the next one.